नमस्ते टू ऑल स्टूडेंट्स, खुश हो बेटिया। माई सेल्फ जेविन डॉक्टर खुशबू वर्मा, फैकल्टी ऑफ एग्रीकल्चर एंड वेटरनरी साइंस। टुडे वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट कॉलोनी एंड प्लेग हाइब्रिडाइजेशन। दिस सेशन इज रिलेटेड टू रिकॉम्बिनेंट डीएनए टेक्नोलॉजी ऑफ प्रोग्राम बीटेक एफबीटी एंड बीएससी बीटी सिक्स ट्रेमेस्टर। सो टेक्निक्स बेस्ड ऑन द न्यूक्लिक एसिड ब्लॉटिंग एंड हाइब्रिडाइजेशन इंक्लूडिंग द कॉलोनी ब्लॉटिंग एंड हाइब्रिडाइजेशन, प्लेग लिफ्ट एंड हाइब्रिडाइजेशन, सदर्न ब्लॉटिंग एंड हाइब्रिडाइजेशन, नॉर्दर्न ब्लॉटिंग एंड हाइब्रिडाइजेशन, डीएनए एंड आरएनए डॉट ब्लॉट एंड ज़ू ब्लॉट हाइब्रिडाइजेशन। सो कॉलोनी ब्लॉटिंग एंड हाइब्रिडाइजेशन इंक्लूडेड द अप्लाइड टू न्यूक्लिक एसिड रिलीज फ्रॉम द ब्लॉटेड माइक्रोबियल कॉलोनीज एंड द मोस्ट कॉमनली यूज एंड रैपिड मेथड ऑफ लाइब्रेरी स्क्रीनिंग as it can be applied to very large number of the probes. And this is the procedure for detection of recombinant colonies by colony blot hybridization. Here we can see, pick any kind of a positive colony and colonies of transformants growing on a agar plates. This plate will contain only colonies which will have the transformant, means they will have the vectors and they can be replicates and non, they can be recombinants or non-recombinant. So first of all, we will go for the positive colony. We will pick that and replica plating on the membrane disc which retain the master plate. And we will retain this master plate and we will prepare a replica plate and this membrane disc with impressions of bacterial colonies. Then we will go for the lyse of bacteria with 0.5 NUH. Then we will go, when we will do the neutralization, then the proteinization by the proteinase, then we will wash and then we will bake at 80 degree temperature. After all these processes, we will get the DNA print or DNA blot. Then we go for the hybridization with a radio labeled probe and we will go for the autoradiograph. Here we will get the autoradiograph and we can see here the target colony will show the dark spot. So this is the whole procedure for the detection of recombinant colonies. They will have a recombinant vector. So this is the complete procedure of colony blotting and hybridization. Here again we can see the procedure. This is the membrane and colonies on the petri plates and blotting cells to the membrane. We will put this membrane on this petri dish which will have the colonies. Then after the putting membrane and transfer the colonies onto the membrane, we will go for the cell lysis, DNA denaturation and fixing on the membrane with the labeled probes. Then incubation with the probes and washing of unhybridized probe, and these labeled probe will bind to only those colonies which will have the recombinant vector, or these probes are basically complementary to the target DNA, so they will attach to those colonies which have the target DNA molecule. So and after the binding of the labeled probe to the specific target colonies, they will show the visualization and here we can detect the hybridized DNA or colonies. Next, we will discuss about the plaque lift and hybridization process. Here we can see that in the flow diagram that plaque recombinant phase, we go for the incubation period and after that cool at 4 degree temperature for 1 hour to stiffen top agar or top agarose. Then we will pick the positive plaque, basically plaque of the transformant growing on the plate. This is the plate which have the transformants, and after the picking of the positive plaque and plaque lift on the membrane and retain master plate. We will put the master plate in a reservation. And after the retention, membrane disc with the impressions of the plaque, we will go for the denaturation, neutralization, washing, and baking at 80 degree temperature, then we will get the DNA print or blot. After the DNA print or blot, we go for the hybridization with the label crop, and then we will go for the autoradiography, where we will get the autoradiograph, where these label crop will show the visualization spot with the recombinant plaque. So this is the complete procedure of the plaque lift and the hybridization process. So if we discuss about the basic basic comparison of colony and plaque hybridization, so here we can see that transfer the DNA in the plaque or colony to a nylon or cellulose nitrocellulose membrane, and phase DNA bind to the membrane directly, or bacterial colonies must be lysed to release the DNA on the membrane surface. After that, we will go for the hybridization in a solution which will be the alkali treatment, in the solution containing the nucleic acid probe. After that, we will go for the washing to remove unhybridized probe and visualization. We can go for the X-ray film. We can go for the antibody or enzyme modified nucleotide label, and then we will line up the hybridized region or repeated hybridization. So this is the complete process of colony and plaque hybridization process. And this session is powered by Digital Version 2.0, Jyoti Vidyapeeth Women's University, Jaipur. Hope you are satisfied with this digital session. If you have any query, then mention in the comment box. I will resolve it. Thank you.